Howdy, Heroes Hearth. Kyle Fergusson here from Into the Nexus podcast, and I'm here to talk to you about Raynor. Now, last week I did a video on micro, the basics of controlling your character better. So what a perfect hero to dive right into this week. The MicroMAN, previously two-button Terry, now has had a bit of an upgrade since his rework, and is the best sustained assassin in the game right now in terms of burden of execution. Now, what is burden of execution? Well, that's the idea that you can perform something easier on one hero than you could another. So for example, we got things like Greymane, Vala, Tychus, Phoenix, all rocking great damage numbers, great heroes. But wouldn't it be easier to just do all that damage with Raynor? And there's no better example of that than Zul'jin. Zul'jin is quest dependent, meaning a lot of his power is hidden behind the You Want Axe quest line. You may also take Headhunter on top of this. Raynor, however, comes with everything in his base kit. His damage is high because it's just high, and that's what makes him so much easier than Zul'jin. But Zul'jin has a self-heal, you say. Well, so does Raynor. Frankly, Raynor has it all. He's got teamfight, he's got counters to powerful enemy abilities, and he has excellent siege damage. And here I mean siege damage in terms of throughput into buildings, not necessarily how sweet your splash damage lane clear stat might be at the end of the game. But I know a lot of people find him boring. They don't want to be playing checkers, they want to play 3D chess. But I'd go against that argument for a moment. Raynor is all about positioning and micro choices. Because you don't have a vault like Vala, or a barrel roll like Falstead, even a dash like Tychus, you have to hand pick, choose exactly where you're going to stand in every single team fight. That takes planning, that takes forethought. Raynor is a finely crafted, deceptively simple hero. And he's a great opportunity to showcase some of those micro options you have. And in that last video, we talked about A moving and hold position with the H. You absolutely do want to be quick casting and stutter stepping with Raynor. There's one option you might want to take advantage of, and it's very much a personal choice. What happens normally is that when you A move, you just attack the closest target, be it a hero or an enemy minion. In the options, under gameplay, you will find the option for enable attack move target point. A moving near a hero will allow you to attack that hero instead. And our auto attacks always favor heroes when things are at a similar distance. So here you can see with my mouse that our A move, because it's located close to me, is still auto attacking the closest hero. If I A move out here, I will advance towards that target. And while I might be kind of bad at aiming this mouse, I can still attack the target I mean to. Now, Raynor has a pretty fast attack speed. So our goal is always to find good positioning with stutter step and then move into a nice plant your feet auto attack wail on the enemy's face. His auto attack becomes even faster when using his W, which we'll get into in a moment. So while you're positioning, you're always looking for that moment where you can finally plant your feet and make sure your auto attack speed is at maximum, that you're doing as much damage as possible. We can imagine on Battlefield of Eternity, the most popular map for Raynor, that we would want to position ourselves near the exit rather than near danger so that we can attack for as long as possible before we would have to break that position and let the enemy take it over. Always be thinking a step ahead when positioning a low mobility hero like Raynor. Raynor is also a great opportunity to talk about animations, also known in the game descriptions as basic attack cooldowns. So every hero has an attack speed. Some have longer animations than others. Some heroes have big swords that swing slowly. You need to be careful you don't move them too soon after trying to make an auto attack, or it'll cancel that animation and the attack won't land. Raynor has a very fast attack animation, as his bullets fly out of his gun, so he can stutter step rather reliably. Inspire provides Raynor and all nearby allied minions and mercenaries with 30% attack speed and 10% movement speed for 4 seconds. Casting Inspire resets Raynor's basic attack cooldown. So what this means is that you can actually attack faster than your auto attack speed. So when you're moving in to auto attack, you want to let that first muzzle flash go, then hit Inspire for a quicker auto attack on the other side. And you can see not only did we increase our attack speed, we got a second auto attack out faster than we would have otherwise. This is a very cool way to optimize a hero that you might be maining, but the text isn't always the same throughout the game. For instance, Butcher's Hamstring does the exact same thing, but it's listed as Butcher's next basic attack will strike immediately. We are canceling his auto attack animation, the cooldown after it, so you can get more auto attacks out faster. So Raynor's got it all, and he has a deceptively simple kit. So we're gonna break down the abilities so you're taking advantage of all that sweet text and value. Give him some pepper. Every fourth basic attack splashes in a small area, dealing 125% bonus damage to the main target. A little bit of lane clear with that splash, but mainly that burst of damage into the primary target. Here you can see, under Raynor's health, that there are diagonal bullets loading up into three, and then the fourth auto attack spends those bullets as the bonus damage. Something you might do when fighting in lane is spend three auto attacks on the lane itself, and then make sure you put that fourth auto attack into a hero so you're making the most of that bonus hit. Penetrating Round deals damage, knocks back, and slows by 20% for 2 seconds. The closer you are to Raynor, the further you are knocked back. On a 10 second cooldown, this is the ETC Mosh counter, the Garrosh disengage, the Mount Ganis disengage, the interrupt for Diablo charges, Blaze charges. Raynor can bring a lot for the team with a simple knockback. Think of face melt on ETC, how universally good that is, and it's just a simple knockback. You have to aim this one a little better than ETC, but Raynor brings a lot to the table with just simple text. Adrenaline Rush, heal Raynor for 25% of his maximum health over 1 second. Raynor's basic attacks lower this cooldown by 0.5. Doubled against heroes, so you get a full second every time you attack a hero. So unlike Vala, Raynor has a self-heal, is less dependent on his team to take care of him and to top him off. Unlike Zul'jin, he can keep fighting during his use of Adrenaline Rush. We are reducing the burden of execution on ourselves, but also our team who has to take care of us. Plus, we should already be in smart positions, so hopefully they'll have to worry about us even less. Now I'm gonna give you a baseline build for Raynor. He is so good in so many different team comps and so many situations, but that baseline is gonna start with Ace in the Hole. Deal 10% more damage to stunned or slowed enemies. Enemy heroes hit by Give 'em Some Pepper are slowed by 10% for 2.5 seconds. Now on our target dummy here, we can see that blue shoe is moving down to 90% as Raynor is hitting his slow. This slow is active for nearly all of Raynor's auto attacks, following the Give 'em Some Pepper burst damage. Even if you don't have additional slows on the team, Ace in the Hole is doing work a vast majority of the time when you're team fighting. Now I don't want to rob you of the stacking sweetness that could be a veteran marksman game, and you might play in that style where you farm 3 attacks on the lane and then make sure you always hit an enemy hero. This could work out great on 2-lane maps, or if you're in a league where everybody's just team fighting all the time. The problem is all this questing is distracting you from the primary purpose of Raynor, which is that his base kit has all of his power. If you are distracted by a quest, you're not paying attention to the essentials of managing your good position and attacking the right target. You might very well farm this on the enemy tank throughout the entire game to find that you've never killed the backline in the first place. Now, Exterminator is an interesting one. By far, Raynor's most popular map is Battlefield of Eternity, and this isn't an awful talent. In fact, this can bring a lot of burn to Battlefield of Eternity. It might help your team make up for a lack of merc campability or objective clear on other maps. When making the choice for Exterminator, you should be thinking about the enemy side. For instance, let's say the enemy team is made up of Garrosh, Alarak, Lucio, and Gul'dan, and the solo lane is Leoric. That team does not have good objective burn for Battlefield Eternity. Because of that, they're more likely to invade, to defend their immortal, and you're gonna have a team fight on your hands. Exterminator will not help you win that team fight, and the other two talents at one would have served you better. But if you find yourself in a burn versus burn scenario, the enemy is more Hanzo Vala based, then absolutely getting more Exterminator to outpace the enemy is going to serve you well there. An Exterminator does work on minions, mercenaries, and monsters. So depending on your league, that could help make up for a lot of lane clear your team's not attending to. But there are better heroes for that lane clear in the first place. Let's focus on putting Raynor where he belongs, pressuring that enemy team with heavy sustained damage. Now, I'm not going to it depends every single talent here, but that Exterminator Ace in the Hole trade-off is such a popular discussion, it was important we spent some time doing it. This is what your overall baseline build is going to look like. This is going to be easy mode. There are choices along the Raynor build that could have a huge impact in very particular scenarios. Fight or Flight at 4 reduces Adrenaline Rush's cooldown by 10 seconds. You also gain 25 armor for 3 seconds. You will likely be healing when under pressure. Raynor is a great counter to our very flighty heroes, like Tracer, Hanzo, and Genji. Being able to give yourself survivability, take care of yourself in those scenarios, means you come out the other side alive while still pressuring those high mobility heroes with a good old-fashioned right-click. Level 7, Unstable Compound, increases the area of Give Him Some Pepper by 15%. Here in our target dummy scenario, we are now splashing Give Him Some Pepper onto the nearby heroes, whereas before, without that bonus 15%, we weren't hitting these additional heroes. It also gives us 10 mana, which really isn't that important for our hero, but it reduces the cooldown of Penetrating Round and Inspire by 1 second every time we trigger that Give Him Some Pepper trait. This is going to be huge when we get to 16. Training Wheels on, Hyperion does a lot. It is a long cooldown on 100 seconds. We should be working towards Banshee Control, but I'm not concerned about that right now. In order to get maximum Hyperion value, it's a very simple equation. Are there 4 enemies in range and a building you would like to destroy? Be sure to angle so it flies over the building for the maximum duration. To sing the praises of Banshee for a moment, the range on it is amazing. It can fly over terrain, it can scout, it can tank for you while getting in range of a building. Banshee is going to supply a lot of bonus DPS, but if you're not paying attention to your basic positioning, it's going to die, you're going to die. So upgrade to this when you're comfortable and you've played enough Raynor. Level 13, there's nothing wrong with Giddy Up. Giddy Up is going to let you get into those safe positions faster and get you to auto-attacking more because you got to that safe position faster and you're ready to wail. Also grants more movement speed during Inspire, which is a nice thing. When you're ready to get a little fancy, however, take a look at Debilitating Rounds. Reduce the mana cost of Penetrating Round, we're not so concerned about that, but it reduces the cooldown of Penetrating Round by 3 seconds. When Inspire is active, Penetrating Round also slows 40% instead of the previous 20. You can start to see this stack building. We've got auto attacks that reduce the cooldown of our Penetrating Round. And now at 13, we have a 7 second Penetrating Round. Reduced cooldowns on Penetrating Round is building to level 16, Paint Them Red. Increase the damage of Penetrating Round by 50% and heal for 90% of the damage it deals to heroes. This is a huge increase to your survivability. It's a pretty darn good increase to your damage as well. Here we have a very low health Raynor. Let's pop that Inspire to increase the slow. A massive heal. Level 20, Execute, increase attack speed by 20%. This means more bullets in the chamber, more Give Him Some Peppers, and more cooldown reductions based on all those auto attacks we're performing across our entire kit. Our auto attacks also deal increased 25% damage to enemies below 50% health, which is fabulous. But even a short video like this has given you a lot to work on. Work on your positioning, your stutter stepping, take advantage of features of the game like attack move target point and canceling animations. I love having a Raynor on my team. You pick Raynor for me, I'll pick Raynor for you. We'll have a great time. He's not boring, there's just a lot you're not reading into because it ain't very flashy. I was Kyle Fergusson. Be sure to like and subscribe here at Heroes Hearth and ring that bell as well. I'll see you next week with more Learn to Play content for Heroes of the Storm.